Home to KTM, the Red Bull ring is fast and furious, and the Austrian manufacturers can now say they're MotoGP winners. Can they make it back-to-back today? This is MotoGP. Short circuit here, 4.3 kilometres, 10 corners, 7 of them right, 3 of them left. The all-time lap record still stands from Marc Marquez. The best race lap, will that be beaten today? That was Dovi on his way to victory last year with a 1:23.827. Three main zones in terms of overtaking hotspots, but of course this is the main one. This was the winning move last year from Andrea Dovizioso over Marc Marquez. It's time to see if we get more drama now. Coming up, Maverick Viñales is on pole position as Yamaha look to end Ducati's run. But the Italian manufacturers have two men fighting on the front two rows. Miller starts second and Dovi starts fourth. Fabio Quartararo defends his championship lead from third on the grid. And on home soil, can KTM make it an amazing back-to-back win in MotoGP with Pol Espargaró starting in fifth? It's a warm welcome to Spielberg in Austria ahead of the fourth round of MotoGP. 5 weeks ago, we kicked off 2020 after a delay to the proceedings. Of course, the virus that has affected the entire world. The new reformed condensed calendar is underway and our European tour continues here to the Red Bull Ring. Who will take the bull by the horns here today? We're delighted to say that despite quite a dodgy looking forecast and a couple of grey clouds still hovering, probably a bit too close to us. But now we've had a dry day and we might just dodge the showers. Steve Day, Matt Burton, and Simon Crafar then to talk you through the fourth race of 2020. And although it's been a short and very quick start to proceedings, we have not been short of stories. Marc Marquez out injured in the first race of the season and we're still waiting to hear on when he returns, likely Misano. Bagnaia out injured, Brad Binder a race winner, Fabio Quartararo. And here in KTM's backyard, Matt, a Ducati dominated circuit, we've got Maverick Viñales on pole, Dovi's leaving Ducati. I mean, where do the stories end? Hopefully we're going to have another bit of drama coming up in the next hour or so.
It's been a Hollywood scriptwriter's dream so far, hasn't it, MotoGP 2020? Maverick Viñales then, the number 12 Monster Energy Yamaha rider. His first pole position since Phillip Island in Australia last October. Only two wins Maverick's ever taken from pole position in MotoGP, none since the French Grand Prix at Le Mans in 2017, when he won three of the first five Grand Prix that year. We just saw there a quick glimpse of your world championship leader Fabio Quartararo on the front row for the 11th MotoGP race in succession. He has not finished off the front row of the grid since the British Grand Prix at Silverstone last August. There was Jack Miller. Will he add his name to an illustrious race-winning Ducati roster here in the Red Bull Ring? This man's done the business, Andrea Dovizioso. Andrea Iannone has won here. Jorge Lorenzo has won here. And the big news in many respects of this Austrian Grand Prix weekend, Dovi's done at Ducati at the end of 2020. Where will Andrea Dovizioso's future in MotoGP be in 2021? That's one of the big questions coming up in the next few weeks or so. The next big questions in the next hour or so is, can anybody stop the dominant Ducatis here in Spielberg?
Here is Alex Rins still fighting through the pain. A brilliant return to action in Andalusia with a 10th when everyone thought he was done, and then even better in Brno just 7 days ago. Fourth place for Alex Rins. He starts in eighth place on the third row today, and even Dovi has picked him out as one to watch at the end of it.
Valentino Rossi, the only rider in the field, no great surprise, that was racing here at the Red Bull Ring when it was called the A1 Ring back in the mid to late 1990s. His first ever world championship podium came here when he was third in 1996. Now, at the moment, thankfully, we're not going to need any Michelin rain tyres. We thought there were going to be some thunderstorms hitting the Red Bull Ring at this time on Sunday, but not the case so far. All so far, so good as far as the weather's concerned. Looks like the rear tyre choice in terms of the slicks will be torn between the medium and the soft, a little bit like it was 7 days ago last weekend at the Czech Republic in Brno.
It was interesting yesterday, Piero Taramasso saying that determining race tyre selection will really depend on the weather, and it's 40 degree track temperature right now.
Well, there is your starting grid, and we've got some advanced information, of course, with our programme starting slightly later. And as we thought, it's quite an even split between soft and medium rears. Paul Espargaro's rolled the dice a little bit, coming to the grid at this stage with a hard front tyre on. And nobody on those first four rows has decided to go with Paul's front tyre choice, Brad Binder. So the two factory KTMs have decided their pick for the front tyre, at least, is that hard front. Bradley Smith, the only other one. So three men in the pack have gone for that hard front tyre. Paul Espargaro, to be fair to him, has had incredible race pace all weekend. He looked really strong in FP4 yesterday. Many people have got him as their pre-race pick. I mean, I think if you were to decide potentially who the podium picks were going to be pre-race, it was anything between Paul Espargaro, Andrea Dovizioso and Jack Miller. Nobody really giving a great hope for the Yamahas.
Well, let's find out whether Paolo Ciabatti thinks that his men can defend that great record here in Austria, with Jack Miller starting from second and Dovizioso fourth. Let's not discount Joan Zarco from proceedings either. He'll be starting ninth. Ciabatti's on the grid now with Simon.
He is, Paolo. Really curious to hear what you think of Dovizioso's chance to come through. I know all of us in the commentary box think he can get to the front. Before we move on to the other riders, tell us what you think.
Well, I think Andrea has shown a very good pace, so I think we have good chances here to do a great race. And actually, everybody expects Ducati to win again, because we did it in the past 4 years. Not so easy this year, I would say. But I think we are in a good situation, both with Andrea and with Jack.
Thank you.
Thanks, Simon. After everything that has happened with Dovi over the last 24 hours, it would be so MotoGP for him to come through and win here.
And Paolo Ciabatti just happy that he had to do an interview where Andrea Dovizioso's future or his decision to quit at the end of the season was mentioned. Always, as always, in the Red Bull Ring, a spectacular aero display. They're still putting on a show, even though there are no fans allowed into, of course, this Spielberg venue. I hope you're enjoying this from the comfort of your sofas at home all around the world.
Yeah, it's a beautiful part of the world, isn't it? What about Suzuki's? They've never had a bike on the podium here in Austria. Their hopes pinned on Joan Mir starting in a season-best sixth and Alex Rins eighth, down to Simon on the grid.
Davide, no podium for Suzuki here at the circuit before, but a lot of people think today it will change. What do you think?
I mean, I think yes, we can be a contender for the podium. Then, of course, you know, the race is unpredictable. But I think both guys had a very good pace through the weekend, and also in the warm-up this morning, John rode quite well. In a good pace, so we do have a pace. Let's see how the start goes and how it develops. But you know, here many riders are strong. The Ducatis are strong. You have to see the Yamaha, how they cope with the tires and performance. So I think we are a contender. Not easy, but we try.
One last thing, Alex managed to finish in Brno, which was truly amazing. Is he in better strength now? Is it recovered some, so you don't think he'll have as much problem in today's race?
Yeah, not sure, because this morning also we saved quite a few energies, making very few laps, and he had some pain, so it's not easy. I think we have to fight again this race and next race with the pain, and then hopefully be okay from Misano. So today will be another race where he has to suffer a little bit, but I hope that he can manage to arrive at the end, same as Brno. Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks very much to Davide Brivio then. So Mir starting sixth. He could definitely do some damage. He was fastest this morning in warm-up. We just saw Quartararo on the front row as well, the world championship leader, number 20, looking to try and get back on the podium as he was here 12 months ago.
Here is Juan Mir. Needs a clean race, doesn't he? Taken out last time out in Brno by Ica La Corona, then struggled for pace in one of the Jerez races. It was an unforgettable weekend in Brno 7 days ago for KTM with their first ever MotoGP victory in the hands of Brad Binder. Do they think they can go for an incredible repeat here, potentially with Pol Espargaró in the home Grand Prix at the Red Bull Ring, or Simon Crafoe? I was with Mike Leitner.
That's what I was thinking, Matt. Mike, you know, I've never put a pole down for a win before, but I have today. I think if he can, you know, not make mistakes, he can win. But more importantly, what do you think he can do?
Yeah, I think he had a very good performance in the sessions, like you say. And yeah, you have to stay steady. You have a very good rhythm. So let's see. I mean, you know, you're racing, many things can change from lap to lap. And yeah, we just take it like it comes. So yeah, he's focused and he has a plan.
Can you give us your thoughts on the other riders on KTMs?
Yeah, Miguel actually is also in a good rhythm, so he can really fight for top 10. But first time here with a MotoGP bike, we felt that, missing also the session, the wet session there. So yeah, he's a little more struggling, but I think Brad, we know Brad is always great performing in race, so you never know what he will do.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think that's the understatement of the century based on his victory 7 days ago. Jack Miller and Fabio here just sharing some views ahead of this race. Big, big day for Jack Miller in particular as he looks to try and get his first podium under his belt of the season.
Yeah, good buddies hanging out together in Andorra, aren't they? Is there some late tyre changes going on? There's a Suzuki mechanic bringing some fresh rubber. Keep an eye on row five for this Austrian Grand Prix, because starting next to each other, after a fairly heated exchange, both on the circuit, off the circuit, and on social media yesterday, Danilo Petrucci starting alongside Aleix Espargaró, who incurred his wrath yesterday.
A little smile on the face there of Danilo Petrucci. Ducati have had a great record here, but Danilo not been able to force his way through. Here comes Marc Marquez making his return to the British GP paddock, and Pecco Bagnaia as well.
A spectacular sight, but not the way I would be entering the Red Bull Ring, to be perfectly honest. I'd prefer him to keep my feet planted firmly on terra firma.
There could be something special on the horizon for this guy today, Joan Zarco. Ninth on the grid, but he has been in around that top five all weekend, on the podium 7 days ago in Brno from pole position.
Do you know, I love this as well, Steve. You know, unfortunately, with the global pandemic, we have not got any spectators in this Red Bull Ring, but the organisers are still willing to put on a great show for everybody watching at home.
Yeah, this is just a brilliant circuit, isn't it? A spectacular facility as well. Can't wait to see fans back in the grandstands here this time next year. Here is Aleix Espargaró then, who had that heated bit of drama with Petrucci here just yesterday.
That's what me and Steve are going to be doing in the break in between the next Grand Prix here in Austria. Well, what about Fabio Quartararo? He is the world championship leader. Franco Morbidelli had a breakthrough first podium in MotoGP last weekend. What about the prospects for the two Petronas Yamaha SRT boys in this Austrian Grand Prix? Well, we can find out from the team boss, Wilco Zeelenburg, who's with Simon.
Firstly, Wilco, it looks like people really thinking hard about tyre compounds. Is that true? I can see you talking to the Michelin rep in depth.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, it's basically a tough decision here at the moment between soft and medium. But yeah, for me personally, I think the start and the first three laps are much more important than the medium of the soft, because both tyres fulfill their job quite well. So I think the trick will be the first three laps. If you have a good start and you can go directly with the top three boys, we have a good chance to be on the podium. But if we struggle and we get into 6th, 7th position and we have to fight with the Ducatis on the straights, then it's going to be a difficult race.
Thank you, Wilco.
Thanks to Wilco Zeelenburg. Yeah. The Austrian national anthem playing out whilst the planes fly over with the nation's flag.
is a spectacular sight overhead, this famous Red Bull Ring circuit.
Great stuff then. Red Bull sure know how to put on a show. Here's one of their riders, Ika Lekuona, 16th on the grid. Got to see the checkered flag. Priority number one here today for the 20-year-old Spaniard.
Just shows how hard it is to predict MotoGP in 2020. Out qualifying Brad Binder, race winner here 1 year ago. Safe landing, boys. Perfectly executed by the two Red Bull parachutists. What a weekend it was last weekend for Sponsorama Racing. A first ever pole position for Johann Zarco, which he followed up with a brilliant podium. And what are the pre-race thoughts here in Austria 1 week later of their team boss, Ruben Chow? Simon.
Yeah, Ruben, tell us, does, well, all of us think it's possible for Zarco to get on the podium. Does he?
A lot of pressure from everybody now, but it's clear yesterday we've been really competitive and we missed only 1/10 of a second in the second split, and we missed the first row, and it's really important here, but we think and we wish that Andrea can hold down a bit the group so we can just be approached or close by the leading group in the last 10 laps. And if he's like this, I think with the potential of the bike and the rhythm of the Johan, then we could dream about it. But top six will be incredible race already.
Thanks, Ruben.
Well, let's hope Johann Zarco is as quick as Ruben speaking.
Well, he's on the race-winning motorcycle from Spielberg last year. The GP19 Ducati in the more than capable hands of the flying Frenchman there. A quick glimpse of Maverick Vinales starting from pole for the first time in 2020. There is Stefan Bradl continuing to replace the injured and absent Marc Marquez, who continues his intensive rehabilitation from that serious right arm injury. The word is, as Steve mentioned, that the 93 will be absent again next weekend. We'll see him back in action for the first of the Misano doubleheaders on September the 13th.
Some good rhythm for Alex Marquez, 18th on the grid. Genuine top 10 shout opportunity here for the reigning Moto2 world champion, riding for Repsol Honda.
Yeah, making some solid progress. First time he's qualified inside the top 20. First time, actually, he's starting a MotoGP race when he hasn't been in 21st place on the grid.
Get well soon. Message from MotoGP to Marc Marquez and Pecco Bagnaia. We're expecting to see Pecco and Marc back, we suspect, in Misano. But our best regards to them both. Matt, this is a really big opportunity here for the likes of Dovi and Miller. If they need to get their names back in the frame in the World Championship, one that's been largely dominated by Yamahas. Quartararo, Vinales and Morbidelli, the top three.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. You've got to feel like for the Yamaha men, it's going to be a case of damage limitation. We know they haven't got the engine performance of the KTM or the Ducati. I think a podium result for Vinales and Quartararo would be a real bonus today. I don't think either of them really feel like they've got a fantastic chance of taking the victory. But who knows? Never say never in MotoGP. And that's certainly the case in 2020.
So, so unpredictable thus far. So many stories and more to come, you expect. Andrea Dovizioso just getting some last minute instructions, some advice here. There's nobody that knows how to win round here better than Dovi.
You feel like it's written in the stars, don't you? 24 hours after dropping the bombshell that he was not renewing his contract for 2021, it's almost scripted that he will somehow find a way to protect Ducati's 100% winning record here in Spielberg.